half of monthly retail payment transactions in the Philippines done through digital channels in 2023, smashing expectations of the Philippine Central Bank. Latest data from the BSP showed the share of digital payments to total retail payments in the Philippines grew to 52.8% in 2023 from 42.1% in 2022. The BSP was hoping to digitalize 50% of retail payments in the country by 2023. To talk more about this feat, we're now joined by Attorney Bridget Rose Messina Romero of the Philippine Central Bank. Okay, so thank you very much, Attorney Bridget, for joining us in the show today.
Very much welcome. Thank you as well, Ingrid.
Okay, so first of all, congratulations for hitting the, you know, more than 50% digital transactions relative to total retail transactions, which is, you know, more than what you expected to achieve for the year. I'd like to ask, what strategies did the BSP implement to achieve its goal of digital payment adoption and financial inclusion?
You're right, April. We did have a very positive result by the end of 2023 because we were able to surpass the 50% target that we set in 2020. As you may be aware, we also set out a roadmap. We call it the Digital Payments Transformation Roadmap. Period 2020 to 2023, where we set back then the ambitious target of having half of the total reach at the end of 2023 and also onboarding at least 70% of Filipino adults into the formal financial system. And so you're right that we were able to reach the target and even surpass it by having 52.8% now of the total retail payments made by Filipinos in digital form. And in the roadmap, we identified there several key initiatives. And we have been working both in the, with the pub and the private sector of these initiatives that touch on first focusing on the digital payment streams that would really have key contributions to the growth of digital payments. Second is we looked at the key digital financial infrastructures that we need to enhance or build on so that we can achieve the two targets mentioned. And the third is to also ensure that we continue to have an enabling regulatory environment by which all of our payment service providers, financial service providers can provide responsible innovation in the digitalization of payments and financial services.
So I'm just curious, like, how important was the role of the private sector in the growth of digital payments in the Philippines? I mean, I'm thinking like one of the major catalysts was the pandemic, but, you know, what about the private sector? What role did it have to play?
The private sector really, they continue to even have a critical role in the digitalization of financial services. And in fact, I mentioned about the digital payment streams as being one of the three pillars under our Digital Payments Transformation Roadmap or DPTR. So under that roadmap, the digital payment streams that we've identified are also data-driven. Since that when we pursue an initiative, whether it's policy or whether it's a specific project, it's based on evidence that we see on which type of payment use case really comprise the bulk of total retail payments. And what we've consistently seen is that merchant payments comprise the bulk of the payment volume. So that would be our payments for goods and services. Whenever we go out on buying medicines to the malls, the department stores, or even our online transactions, these are types of merchant payments. And another type of payment use case that we focused on is to make our person-to-person fund transfers more efficient and faster and convenient, essentially. So these are the two use cases that we really focused on under the roadmap. And we worked with the payments industry. It's being led by the Philippine Payments Management Inc., whose members are comprised of banks and non-bank e-money issuers, submit of innovative solutions that target really the digitalization of these types of payment use cases. So you saw the launch of our national QR code standard, which we call QRPH, for use of fund transfers from person to person, and now you can see them being widely used across different stores all over the Philippines. And we also have been broadening the merchant base that has been accepting payments digitally. And likewise, we're also working with the industry to make payment services more affordable, as we see this as being a critical component as well of even accelerating digital payments adoption among the different segments of our society.
And as more Filipinos turn to digital payments, I'm just curious how the BSP is enhancing the security of such payments, because of course that's one of the major issues right now.
Yes, that's correct. Enhancing the security is directly touching on ensuring that there's trust and confidence in the use of digital payment services. So it is very important for us to maintain it. And that is where we always emphasize that each of us have a role to play. As regulators, we also remain vigilant. We look at what is happening in the ecosystem, and we also try to provide more responsive policies and regulations. And likewise, the supervised financial institutions also ensure that they not only comply, but they are also proactive in terms of ensuring that their account holders are not just informed, but they are also providing the appropriate consumer redress mechanisms to their clients. And finally, each of us, as users of digital payment services, it's also our duty to be informed of how we can protect ourselves, how we can protect our funds, our accounts, and overall, in general, the responsible use of digital payments and financial services. And we have been working with the private industry to make sure that we address any emerging risks or trends that we see with respect to cybersecurity or frauds so that we can continue to build trust and therefore grow digital payments usage throughout the country.
What about financial institutions? I mean, how are they coping with increasing demand of digital payments? Because, I mean, it's been quite a steep adoption, the speed at which it happened.
Yes. So what we have been hearing from financial institutions is they welcome all of the innovations that the BSP, as the regulator, spearheading since back in 2015. During the pandemic, it was also very fortunate that the industry, together with the BSP, were able to put all of these interoperable payment rails that we now know as PESONet, InstaPay, and QRPH in place, especially, when we had mobility restrictions. And now they're really seeing the benefits. It's making also their operations more efficient. They are able to reach a wider customer base. For example, you can do eKYC now. That's electronic know your customer. Unlike before, you have to go to a branch and then you have to queue up to be able to open an account. But now you only have to have a mobile phone, of which, based on our data, we see that definitely majority of Philippines have a smartphone already. And then you download the mobile app of your institution of choice, and then you can easily open an account in a matter of minutes. So they are also appreciative of this, and they also are taking advantage, of course. And this goes hand in hand with other projects as well of the government in which we're involved with, like the use of the eKYC feature of our national ID system. They're also on their own educating their clients on cybersecurity feature enhancements as well as the cyber hygiene practices that we are also espousing.
So finally, what's the next target of the BSP after breaching the 50% threshold?
After the 50%, as you know, at some point, increasing our digital payments usage may be even more ambitious. But of course, the hard work would not deter us in pursuing more ambitious goals. And in fact, in our Philippine development plan, we have already committed to increase the digital payment usage in the country from the range of 60% to 70% by the end of 2028. And what we envision there is that we want to be able to onboard new users of digital payments. And I say that coming from the context that currently Our increase in digital payments usage is based on one, there are new users as well that were onboarded during the pandemic, and these users are also multiplying their transactions in terms of digital form. In the future, we want to have more members of the Filipino population to start using digital payment services as well. We want more unique users of digital payment services performing their transactions digitally. We plan to achieve this seemingly more ambitious target by the end of 2028. Again, we will still broaden and deepen the use of our existing interoperable payment rails. And we also have a lot more of exciting and definitely more responsive digital payment services that we have been working with the payments industry in the coming years.
Okay, so anyway, so with that, I'd like to thank you very much, Attorney Bridget, for your thoughts on, financial inclusion, digital payments, and congratulations again to the BSP for hitting that ambitious target. And I hope your more ambitious target will again be achieved in the next few years. Congratulations, and have a good weekend.